With iOS 15, Apple added a new feature specially for Safari, and that is web extensions. I really like this feature just because it's adding a charm to my browsing experience. Do you want to know which Safari extensions I'm using on my iPhone and probably will be helpful for you? Then watch this video till the end. Hello everyone, I'm Nikhil from iGeek's blog, and today let's talk about the Safari web extension. But before we jump in and start exploring the suggestions, let me tell you one thing. There are two different types of Safari extensions. One is embedded, which runs all the time in background and requires some permission from the Safari settings. And the another one is a manual. And that is like, that don't need any explanation, right? Just because it requires manual action to run that web extension. Confusing, right? Not to worry, I'll explain the type of extension with each suggestion, and you can find the suggested extension links in the description down below. Now, let's talk about the very first extension, and that is dark browser. Some fine website like iGeek's blog offers native dark mode support, and some choose not to offer this function to their users. But with the help of dark browser, this function is right at your fingertip. This is an embed type of Safari extension, which means it will run in the background once you set it up. Now navigate to Settings, Safari, Extensions, and from here select the dark browser and toggle it on. Also, allow this extension for all the websites. Now head over to Safari and open a website that does not support dark mode. Tap on the double A icon and select dark browser. Select on from the enabled and tap on done. Now this website has a dark mode. Isn't it great? And the next extension is great too, and that is Pocket. If you are a reader or a researcher and love to create a reading list, then Pocket can be the best companion for you. And this is really great tool to segregate your reading list. Install Pocket app and sign up for a new account or log in with your existing account. Now it will ask to enable the extension to Safari. Give access to it. This is a manual type of extension and we can access it from the share sheet. Just tap on the share icon and you can add URL to your Pocket reading list. The next Safari extension that I'm using the most, and that is Grammarly. And I guess this extension does not need any explanation. Just like I don't need to explain you why you need to subscribe to my iGeek's blog channel and turn on all the notification, right? Install Grammarly app on your iPhone and log in with your free or paid account. This is embed type of extension and requires enabling it from the Safari settings to run in the background. Do that now every time you are typing something. This extension will help you to correct this sentence. The next Safari extension is for the person who often make online purchases. Install Honey Coupons and Reward app and enable the extension from the Safari settings. This is an embed Safari extension, and this is one of the most popular web extension for years now. At the time of exploring shopping sites on Safari, this extension will look for the offers or coupon codes and will pop up the discounts coupon. And that's how we can make a purchase, that too with discounted price. The next Safari extension, Chip, is again helpful to save money at a time of flight booking. Install Chip Flight Deals by Chip on your iPhone. This is an embed extension and we need to turn it on from the Safari settings. Once you do that, head over to the application and set it up. Now open google.com in Safari and search for the flights with the IATA codes. Let me search for the flights from the New York to Las Vegas, like JFK to LAX. And boom, right below the search text box, it will show the cheapest flight option. After saving some bucks, it's time to remove roadblocks. The next Safari extension is to block ads, cookies, social media widgets, and more. Install RoadBlock, and this is embed Safari extension, so we need to activate it from the Safari settings. Now navigate to RoadBlock app to tweak some settings. First is the ads and tracker feature, which is free. With this, we can block ads, hide ads, and block trackers. And with the premium features, we can block or hide social media widgets, privacy banner, resources like images, media, scripts, and more. I personally love this extension as it helps me to avoid distractions from the ads. I must say, you should give it a try. How about installing an extension that can automatically handle cookie consent based on your preference? Download Super Agent for Safari, which deals with cookies. This is again embed Safari extension, and we need to turn it on from the Safari settings. For this extension, I would like to change the permission to allow it for all the website. Now move back to the application and sign up for the app. After that, pick the settings for your cookie preferences, for advertising cookies, functional cookies, performance cookies, or others. Now you don't need to attend consent pop-up for preferred cookie settings, and this Safari extension will get the job done for you. Now, three Safari extensions are left, and the next one is for the developers. Download Web Inspector extension. This is an embed Safari extension, so we need to activate it from the Safari settings. Now open a website and tap on a AA icon and select Web Inspector. And it will view the HTML version of that web page, and you can alter it and can view the live changes. Next is Pinterest. And I guess it does not need any explanation. This is a manual type of Safari extension and needs action to perform a task. If you have installed and have updated version of the Pinterest, then it will be available in the share sheet. Just select Save to Pinterest, pick the board, and it's done. And the last one is Momentum, which is one of the most popular extension on Chrome, and now it's on Safari. With Momentum, we can personalize the Safari start page and convert it into a smart dashboard. Install Momentum app, and this is an embedded Safari extension and needs permission to run in the background. Give permission and select Momentum for open new tabs. Now, every time you open a new tab, it will welcome you with inspirational photos and quote every day. You can set daily goals, track your to-do list, and lot more. And these are the Safari extensions I'm using the most on my iPhone. Do let me know in the comment section down below which Safari extension you are using the most on your iPhone, iPad, and Mac. And along with that, like this video, share this video, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And one more thing, download our all new iGeeksBlog app to enjoy exclusive content about everything Apple. Now allow me to say goodbye. I'm Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.